it's good, 'cause I'm complicated. I sure do know how to tell a lie. Some people say I ain't worth saving. Sometimes I think they're right. Secret, I can say it. I get it wrong most of the time. But looking at you right now, baby, you're the one thing I got right.
Today, and I think that a lot of us were here about a year ago when Uber stood in this exact spot and knelt, and he said to Francie, "Honey, I love you, and I think we need to get the government involved." Seriously. Thanks everybody for joining us. Francie and Uber asked this to be a fun ceremony, so we'll do that. So we're here to have a good time these next few minutes, so while we get this hitching done. And then we'll all have even more fun when the reception starts. Just one little housekeeping thing before we begin. As we all know, Francie and Uber asked for a 70s theme. Well, one of the big things of the 70s was streaking. So we are asking that nobody streak during the ceremony. And if you do choose to streak, please wait until after dark and avoid all lighted areas.
Yeah, I can.
Okay. All right, who gives this bride to this man?
We do!
All right, just a little history on how Francie and Uber's journey started. A little over 5.5 years ago in the small town of Tabiona, Utah, Francie was having a night out with girls. And she got a little overserved. The rest of the girls. And they needed a ride around town. Well, Tabiona is so small they don't have any taxis or Lyfts or Ubers or anything. And one of the girls in the party said, "I happen to have a cousin who lives here." So they called up Lynn at the time and said, "Can you come drive these girls around?" And in Uber's words, he was driving a bunch of drunk bitches. And they were so drunk at one point, there was a baby, an elk calf running alongside the car, and the girls didn't even notice it. That's the night that he became Uber. On their first date, Uber drove 2 hours to take Francie out to dinner. He sent Francie a text asking for her address so he could be at the house and be the polite kind of guy that he is. Francie sent him the wrong address. Uber, it was an address that did not exist, and Uber drove in circles for 2 hours before he finally decided to wait in the mall parking lot, hoping that Francie would text him again, and Francie finally realized, uh-oh, and sent him the right address. They had a variety of other ventures along the way. Uber getting snotted on by an elk. Francie getting her hair pulled by a bison. They were making pecan pies and they used salt instead of sugar. And then they also dyed Uber's beard blue after his last chemo treatment. So anyway, this thing isn't gonna start itself, so let's get to it. We hold marriage up as a tradition in this country and we've debated over it a lot in the last few decades. But at the end of the day, why do we do it? I made the joke in the intro about loving each other so much we're going to get the government involved. But is that really all it is? Of course not. It's a tradition, yes, but we change traditions all the time. We keep the essence of those traditions alive in their new forms. So nowadays, marriage isn't what it used to be, like when Ralph Crandon would say to Alice, straight to the moon, back in the 50s. So anyway, nobody's allowed to knock anybody straight to the moon anymore, and no matter how hairy things get. One of the reasons, crux of the marriage, why we do this marriage thing is, sure, it's a lot of work, takes a lot of compromise, but at the end of the day, when you're married, you've got someone to come home to. You've got someone who's promised to love you no matter how smelly your socks got, no matter how bad your mood is, no matter what the universe decided to drop on your head this week. And you've also got somebody to have spaghetti fights in the kitchen with, someone to laugh at the same silly inside jokes, and while you're finding you've even got someone you share a little inside language with. We do marriage because it helps to have someone to walk through life with. Okay. Francie and Uber, I can't think of two people more suited through life together than you guys. In the time we've gotten to know each other, you certainly both made me smile. And I've seen that your marriage will be built on a foundation of love and trust. And that's the best shot any of us can give it. You'll need to depend on that foundation of trust and love throughout your marriage. You'll need to be more patient than you've ever had to be before. You'll experience higher highs and lower lows than ever before. But now you'll be in it together for good. Okay, with that in mind, let's get some of these legal boxes checked off. Francie, do you take Uber to be your lawfully wedded husband, to love and comfort him for better or for worse, in sickness and in health, and reap any and all tax benefits for as long as you both are there? Do you take Francie to be your lawful wedded wife, to love, comfort her for better or for worse, in sickness and health, and you too to reap any and all tax benefits?
I do.
Okay. All right, it's time now that we do the circle of love. So Uber, if you can repeat after me, are you all set?
Yep.
Francie, I give you the circle of love as a symbol that I will love you, honor you, and cherish you. I know you're supposed to repeat after me.
Oh, I'm sorry. Can
we start over?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. Francie, I give you this circle of love as a symbol that I will love you, honor you, cherish you.
What he said.
And that I'll let you have the remote every once in a while, and I will try to clean up after myself.
Hey, could have said it better.
All right, Francie, it's your turn. So if you could repeat after me. Uber, I give you this circle of love as a symbol that I will love you, honor you, cherish you.
I give you the circle of love as a symbol that I will love you, honor you, and cherish you.
And I'll try not to nag you about spending too much time with the guys, and I will do my best to watch commercial-free TV.
Yeah. What he said.
All right. Well, after that touching exchange, there's only one thing left to do, and that's for me to do my part. And by the power vested in me by the state of Arizona, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Everybody, it's my honor and privilege to be the first one to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Uber Haas. Okay, well, that wraps up the formal portion of today's proceedings. Francie and Uber will greet you in a few minutes at the back door, and then after we get done with the greeting, we have some government paperwork we've got to sign. And then on behalf of Francie and Uber, I'd like to thank you for coming. Now let's get out of here and get on with the party.
All right.
Congratulations.
Yay.
I guess that's for a minute.
Thank you, everybody.
Love you too, man.
Thank you.
Okay. Squiggy, you gonna come?
Couldn't be better.
He wants to go with them?
Yeah, I think so.
They want me to take you.
There we go.
I don't think that's where I was. I didn't know where the dog walked or that.
Awesome job, awesome job, dude.
So,
all right. Yeah, my lip will fall off.
Congratulations, Uber.
Thank you very much.